Hello everyone, welcome back to the Microsoft Excel tutorial journey with me on my Knowledge Factor YouTube channel. This is the 45th session. Today let's take a look at one more type of object that we can insert inside of Microsoft Excel. Now what I'm about to show you here, we are going to just touch upon the feature. There's much more that we can do here, but at this level we are going to see how to insert SmartArts. Now SmartArt is not just an Excel feature. You could use this inside of Word, you can use it inside of PowerPoint. Now for me personally, I use it inside of PowerPoint more than any other Office application, and I think you are going to see why here in just a moment. But SmartArt will allow you to create the diagrams. So watch this. I'm going to stick on this same monthly budget worksheet. I'm going to go up into my Insert tab and back into the Illustration section. Same place we found pictures and shapes, and towards the right I have got the SmartArt. I'll give that a click and it's going to open up my choose up smart graphic interface, and I've got all sort of categories here. I'm currently in all, right? So let's take a quick moment here and I can scroll through and see all the different types of diagrams that I can create. So I have got things like just list diagrams. I want to create just a list. Maybe I want to list with headers. Maybe I don't want to let headers. I want just a simple list, kind of more dynamic and involved bold list, right? That's where your list is smart art going to be. If I scroll down, you got the process smart arts, where you are thinking more. There's actually got a series of steps you are going to go through. Here's step one. Maybe I have got some sub steps there that go along with that. Then I'll go to step two, any sub steps for that, and so on. So you see, I have got all sort of options there, and then I have got cycle. So something you're going to go through a process, right? But it's something that's going to repeat itself, right? You're going to start, let's say, step A, then you're going to go through, and then you're going to repeat, and then go through, and then going to repeat, and then go through, and then going to repeat, and so on, right? Now you have got a hierarchy as well, hierarchical smart art. These diagrams you can pull from things like an organization chart, right? Your family tree, things like that, and so on. So got all sorts of options inside of here, right? And they got office.com, the last option, if you see here, where online Microsoft offers lots of other options that are not just built there out of box in Microsoft Excel, but you can download from office.com. Now this is the same that goes for images as well, that you get from the Microsoft, if you remember from the last lectures. So for me right now, I'm going to pick one. I think I'm going to go into the process, right? And I'll leave this up to you once you know how to work with one of them. They're all very similar there. So look and feel is going to be a little bit different, right? That's why they got so many. But the general idea of creating and editing is going to be same. So let's see. So I'm going to grab this big arrow one here. Continuous block process, and it's written like used to show a progression or sequential steps in a task, process, or workflow, right? That's cool. I'm going to hit OK there, and there's my nice little smart art graphic. What I'm going to do here, just to make it a little bit easier to see on my screen, so there's my nice little smart art graphic. Now once I have got that graphic out there with this selected, I did get a couple of new tabs. If you see here, smart art design, formats, and all. So once I have got that graphic out there with this selected, I did get a couple of new tabs. I got the smart art design tab, I got the format tab. So the design tab got all sorts of operation up there. You got layouts, you can change from the different types of process smart arts. You got styles you can pull from, and then you have got the build or edit the graphic itself, like add additional shapes, delete shapes, promote or demote areas of the shape, and so on, right? And then on the format tab, if you go to the format, you get into the nitty-gritty and you can really start to, you know, format it, change colors and text and so on, right? Now, something to help us out a little bit with changing the text on here, I'm going to go to the smart art design, right? On the left hand panel, I'm going to open up the text pane. There it is. So this is on my little text panel on the left hand side. So now I can just edit the text. You can edit it directly in the graphics as well. I just find it much easier to edit over here, but there are options to edit it from the images or from the text pane. So let's see, this is my monthly budget. So what do I want to put in here? I'm going to you know, put few steps from my monthly budget. So I'm going to say the step one, the first step, make money, right? Make money, that's step one. All right, so yeah, I mean, in order to have a budget, in order to spend that money, you got to make the money in some way, right? That's just reality, whatever that making involves, right? But you got to make the money. That's step one. All right, then step two, spend money. So spend money. Alright, yeah, so next step, this is one that I struggle with. So like I said, you can edit it directly in the graphic. If I click here, you can edit in the graphic, or you can do it inside the text pane, just show the difference. If I click into there, in one I struggle with, right? I just spend my money all day, right? My problem is tracking money, right? Like, where it's going at the end of the month, as like, oh god, my wallet is empty, right? And where did it all go, right? Now I got to go back and figure it out. Bills for the entertainment, right? This is why we got Excel, though. It can help you track it. I just got to stay on top of it. That's my challenging part. All right, so just to right here, track money. So there's my three step: make the money, spend the money, and track it. So this is my little smart art graphic. I think they are pretty sleek. Like I said, I use them more so inside of Microsoft PowerPoint than I do inside of Excel. But you can use them in Excel, PowerPoint, Word. Microsoft Visual has actually got its own tools for you to got in there, create your diagrams and whatnot. But you have got smart art diagrams built inside of Microsoft Excel, and really simple them to make those simple edits with. They got all your tools are at the top of the screen. Now I must show you actually one more thing here. I have got some main talking points that are going to, you know, go through this process, right? Making money, spend money, and track money. Well, what if I want a little sub element inside there, right? Like I wanted to say make money, and then I want to sub bold it inside, and there are sub elements that say I'm going to make money by working, I'm going to make money by asking my mom, I'm going to make money by, and so on. So you'll notice if I click on the right of my bullet here, make money, if I hit enter key, now default, hit my enter key and it creates a new shape for me. That's very sleek, right? I can also go to my smart design and add shape here, but really simple, just to get in there and hit your enter key and you got new shape. Now if I hit my backspace right now, it will delete that shape back out. And I could do that with any of these shapes. Delete the text, delete the bullet, gone. Well, if I hit my enter key, I get into shape, but it's not really a next step that I want. It's a sub step. So what I'm going to do with my cursor there, I am gonna hit my tab key once on my keyboard. Well, that moves the tab over the shape one away, right? Let's say work, put some text in there, work, and I will hit my enter key, and there's my work sub bold. Now next, can say ask my mom, right, and so on. And I come over here and hit my enter key again. Got new shape now, and I'll hit again the tab key. Then I can do a sub bullet here underneath my spend money. So you say you got bills, you got a play, right? So I'm going to go see a movie or whatever it might be, and so on. Just movie, play, and so on. So that's how we got those sub bullets points as well. So try this out, and then you get some time, right? Pause the videos, take a little break for a little while, get in as your smart art and do some formatting, change the colors, change the fill color, just like your insert shapes or they are like your arrow and your smiley face, right? It's all going to be the same. And you could select different shapes in there, like the arrow and the box and the text, whatever it is that you're formatting there. Give this a go, right? Pretty cool, much more visual than just a bunch of numbers inside of an Excel document. Thanks for watching this tutorial. And as I always say, if you really liked it, enjoying this journey, then please do like, share, and subscribe my channel. And also press the bell icon to get the latest content update on this channel. Alright then, we'll meet up in the next session. In case you have any questions, any concerns, then do let me know in the comment section of this video. Till the time, goodbye and take care.